camera lady. Hey, Nydia.
Hello, Mr. Bushell. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Doing great. Thank you.
Doubly hot.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello. I admire your work.
Oh, thank you so much.
You're doing a wonderful job.
And tell me your name, please.
Irma Christy.
Irma, it's a pleasure to meet you.
I've been following you on websites and just everything that's been going on. And I really admire you for doing that. And I think you have every right to be here. And I'm glad that you're doing what you're doing.
Well,
it's awesome.
Thank you, Emma.
Charlie, good to see you.
Hi there.
Hey, sir. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
How are you? Good to see you. How are you?
Lauren McDonald.
Yes, sir. Oh, gosh. How are you? Good to see you.
How are you?
Super camera woman, huh?
So they say. I've heard that before, yeah.
Hello, how y'all doing? Good to see you.
How you doing? How are you?
Hello, Mr. Bennett. I'm doing very well.
This is my wife, Carol, my son, Charlie, and my other son, Nathan.
Hello, Nathan, and Charlie, and Carol. It's a pleasure to meet you all.
She's the one who videoed the commission meeting that was in.
Oh, the YouTube video.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
She's excellent.
Yes.
Good video.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that.
Oh, like this sweet little lady.
It's a pleasure.
People have to work all that much harder to get the new ones to see things their way. Yeah, thanks, Tom. It gives us an opportunity.
I should be the lady though.
Yes, I am.
Hey, I'm not getting lost. What time is it, sir? Good to see you. Yeah. Good to see
you. You're on, Donald.
Oh no, my image is not for public consumption. It's personal property of mine.
I really like your outfit, though. See what happens when
you start expressing yourself.
I like your outfit.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Did they apologize to you for doing it?
No, nor do I expect an apology. And that's why there's a lawsuit.
I don't mind being on security camera. As long as nobody makes any money on my image, which is priceless.
Oh my lord.
You were in the paper.
Yes, Nydia Tisdale.
Lydia, I'm Ron Densmore.
Oh, Ron Densmore, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Good to meet you.
I recognize the name.
I'm going to give Nydia plenty of room, see if she gets mentioned during the debates tonight.
I wasn't always
there. Hello,
Nydia. How are you?
I'm doing great, thank
good.
You.
Good luck, guys.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Take your chair. Actually, right up the frame. I'll be fine.
joining us for our next debate. We have a very important role at the Coroner, and we appreciate very much our three candidates who are seeking the Republican nomination. Joining me first on my left is Mr. Hal Bennett. On his left, Mr. Mark Musselwhite. On his left is Ms. Mary Beth Pais. Thank you all for joining us tonight. If you're not familiar with the microphone, if the red light's on, the folks out in the crowd can't hear you, so make sure that you turn your mic off on when it's time for the for you to speak. As in all of our debates, each candidate will be given 2 minutes to make your opening statement. From there, we will move on to our question period. Each candidate will have 1 minute to answer the question. We'll move on down the line, and you'll have an opportunity for either additional comments or rebuttal. The intention is to try to create a dialogue between the candidates. Please do keep an eye on Mr. Joel Knight, who's down here in the crowd. He'll be keeping the clock and remind you to stay on time. Finally, we'll be wrapping up, and each candidate will have a minute and a half to make their closing remarks. We'll begin. Mr. Halbert.
Thank you. I appreciate everybody coming out and staying this late, because I know you'd rather be home watching something else besides us. But my name is Hal Bennett. I'm running for the position of coroner. I have over 23 years working with the medical examiner's office. I have 20 years military experience. I have over 30 years of being a nurse. I'm a member of this community, have been for 8 years. I go to Brownsbridge Community Church. Prior to that, we went to North Point Community Church with Andy Stanley. I was a Hope minister there when I went to church, so I got a chance to deal with families and people, individuals during times of need. I think that I'm very well qualified for this job, and I'm hoping that during the course of this debate, that the information that I'm able to give you will allow you to make up your mind to choose the best candidate for this county. And regardless of who you choose, this will be the person I'm sure that will do the best job. Thank you.
Mr. Musselwhite.
Yes, sir. Good evening. My name is Mark Musselwhite. Thank you all for being here and being involved in local politics. I'd like to thank the Republican Party for organizing and hosting this event. It's a unique opportunity for coroners to be able to stand here and debate before you. I want to tell you, I'm not a politician. I'm a husband, I'm a father, and I'm a concerned taxpayer with a willingness and ability to serve my community. My name is Mark Musselwhite, and I want to be Forsyth County's next coroner. I'd like to thank my wife, Jessica, and our daughter, Brooke. I'm sure you guys hear Brooke making some noise back there. For their continued support. Thank you for being here tonight. We live in South Forsyth County. We worship at Peachtree Corners Baptist Church. I have a business degree in marketing from Georgia College of State University. I worked in sales and in customer service before answering my calling to the death care industry. I currently serve the coming of Forsyth County communities as a licensed funeral director in Walmart, where I'm able to express my God-given abilities to show compassion to others. You know, being a coroner and a funeral director are not so different. They both require that you're on call 24 hours, and my wife can tell you that includes nights, weekends, holidays, and anniversaries. They both are very physically and emotionally demanding jobs. They both require someone who can show compassion to loved ones of the deceased. Please visit my website, Musselwhite4coroner.com. Like our Facebook page to stay in touch. And most importantly, vote Musselwhite on July 31st. Thank you.
Ms. Mary Beth Pais.
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm so grateful that you decided to stay. I am Mary Beth Pais. I'm a candidate for coroner. I feel as though I am the most qualified candidate. I'm a registered nurse and have been for over 30 years. I have worked in emergency rooms, both large and small. I've been a supervisor, a manager, most currently an educator. I'm on the faculty of the Birdie F. Lewis School of Nursing at Georgia State University. I hold both graduate and undergraduate degrees in nursing and education. I am a trained medical legal death investigator from the University, St. Louis University School of Medicine, and I have taken call as a deputy coroner for Tallapoosa County in Alabama, and I currently, and have been for the past 5.5 years, been a volunteer at the Alabama Forensic Lab in Montgomery. And last but not least, I'm a proud alumnus of the Forsyth County Citizens for Law Enforcement Academy. I have my education, my training, my desire, the support of my family has led me to make this commitment to the citizens of Forsyth County. I feel I can provide the very best of respectful and dignified care to the decedent, and I can certainly provide compassionate and empathetic care for the loved ones left behind. This is a calling. Not everybody can do this. Not everybody should do this. And I feel as though I can be the voice for the one who is now silent. I thank you very much for listening. I hope that you'll vote for me on July 31st. Thank you.
Thank you for giving us a little insight into what y'all do. Our first question, I'll allow you to expound upon that. We'll start with Mr. Bennett. What qualifications do you have to make you the best candidate to serve as coroner?
I hold a bachelor's degree from Oglethorpe University. I've worked on forensic anthropology for a master's at University of New Orleans under Dr. William Bass, who was the head of the anthropology department at the University of Tennessee and the founder of the Body Farm. I've had numerous classes and training in forensic investigations. I trained with Joe Davis at Dade County Medical Examiner's Office, also the Dade County Law Enforcement Academy and blood spatter interpretation, homicide investigations, in interview techniques, cold case work. I was in law enforcement since 1973. I am a post-certified police officer. I am also a nurse and have had a license since 1972.
Mr. Musselwhite?
You know, that's a good question. I started my career out of college in customer service. I moved into a sales role. I have a bachelor's degree in marketing. There is a budget involved in the coroner's office, so from that aspect, I think I'm well qualified. The budget is more like a average household budget here in Forsyth County. Last year, I think it was $147,000 and some change. As far as the investigative side of the job, you know, we have county investigators here, and that's what they do. There is some investigation that goes into that, but the coroner works in correlation with the GBI to do that investigation. And he doesn't step on the county investigator's toes. They have a job to do as well. He works in harmony with them.
Ms. Pais.
I agree with Mr. Musselwhite. I think it's important at this point in time that people be aware that there is a difference. There's so much on television today with regards to forensic investigators, CSI. I am a trained medical legal death investigator. I investigate a person who is deceased. It is not my responsibility to deal with the scene. We have a wonderful Forsyth County Sheriff's Department that has wonderful crime scene investigators, forensic investigators with whom I would be collaborating with in regards to my findings. My experience and expertise is medical, it is pharmacological, it is based on 30 plus years of trauma care, as well as being a supervisor, a manager, an educator of all the nurses that take care of you. And as such, I feel that I have a wealth of knowledge in addition to the fact that I did continue to train after I initially trained at St. Louis University. I continued year after year to update. Thank you.
Mr. Bennett, do you think about that?
Yes. I too am a trained medical legal death investigator and certified by Dr. Davis at the Dade County Medical Examiner's Office. The classes I took there with him are the same type of classes Ms. Pais took. I've also been with the medical examiner's office for Gwinnett and Cobb County for 23 years. During that time, I investigated over 300 deaths a year involving everything from natural deaths to homicides. I have worked very closely with police departments under all jurisdictions. I have worked with the medical examiners at the state crime lab. I am very familiar with the cooperation that is involved working with all of these people. So I feel that my qualifications very well make me suited for this position.
Mr. Musselwhite?
Sure, I'd now like to say, as a funeral director, I am able to show compassion to people they need it most. And we deal in death every day, and that's what we do. So I'm very well exposed to that. Again, the investigative side, Mr. Bennett, with all due respect, we do not have a medical examiner system here in Forsyth County, and that's for good reason. It's because we couldn't do that with the $147,000 budget. Ms. Pais, I respect your qualifications as well, but you know, a dead person does not need a nurse. You know, there is a benefit to having a medical background and being able to speak that language as a liaison between the GBI and the investigators and the people. That's what a coroner does.
Ms. Pais,
excuse me, please.
Would you like to add anything?
Yes, I understand where these gentlemen are coming from, and I respect their opinion. However, I do think that it is critical for an individual to be well aware of all of the different medical and surgical issues that may arise as a result of a person and being able to identify that on an individual and being able to share that and being able to understand that because of this, therefore, approximately the following things can occur. And having that knowledge base is extremely valuable. And it's valuable not only for the individual that's deceased, but for the family as well. And I truly believe that I can provide just as compassionate care as certainly anyone else on this panel, and I assure you I've had to do that for many years in an emergency room when I've had to tell someone's loved one that their family is gone.
I hope you all have painted my questions.
Because my next question was, this is from Mr. Musselwhite, do you perceive the coroner's office as more of a medical position or as a law enforcement role?
There are both, obviously. There are two sides to that. The coroner, again, works in harmony with the investigators, whether that's the county or the city. We have great guys and girls in both. And so, again, it's great to have medical background experience. I do have plenty of those courses that I've taken, anatomy, psychology, I can name microbiology, pathology, etc. I can speak that language to the extent that I can relate to the GDI and back to the people. That's where the coroner is. He's the eyes and ears and the hands and feet on the scene that can relate to the GDI and relate back to the people and to the investigators.
Ms. Pais? Would you like to repeat the question?
Would you please?
Sure. Do you perceive the coroner's office as more of a medical position or a law enforcement role?
It is predominantly a medical position with a legal aspect to it, and that's the forensic part of it. I do feel that it is important, and I have spoken with other coroners and other deputy coroners, and they do feel that it is most advantageous for individuals to have a medical background to assume these responsibilities. And it's certainly, with the experience that I've had, it makes the most sense. Truly it does. If you were to attend the classes that certainly probably I have and Mr. Bennett has, you would find that it is imperative that you have a thorough knowledge of medical care and surgical care, and all of these other aspects of it are important. But again, we have crime scene investigators. My concern is with the thank you.
Mr. Bennett, do you perceive the coroner's office as more of a medical position or as a law enforcement role?
I consider it both. It's important, when I look at a case, it's, I determine whether or not that person has to go to the crime lab for an autopsy. As a coroner, that's what you do. You have to look at it from a law enforcement aspect and see, has there been a crime involved? Is there something criminal involved in this death? Then you turn around and put on your other cap, where as a nurse and working emergency room, intensive coronary care units, I have to look at it medically, did this person die as a result of a medical issue? If it is a medical issue and I can document it, then there's no need for that person to have to go to the crime lab for an autopsy, delaying the family and receiving their death certificate. If it's a criminal aspect, then the family certainly wants me to make sure that the police department works hand in hand with the coroner in order to solve that crime or solve that death.
Mr. Musselwhite, I thought I saw you shaking your head. You were up.
I just want to clear the air. Again, we do not have a medical examiner system here in this county. And the reason being is it would cost a lot of money. The five guys that normally sit here wouldn't approve that budget. We operate within a $147,000 budget. That's what the $147 and some change was what the actual dollars were that were spent last year. Do I think there's room for improvement on that? Certainly. And I have some great ideas for doing that. I'd like for you all to visit my website and check those out. But the coroner does answer to the GBI. The GBI ultimately determines whether or not that autopsy is done. It's not the coroner. The coroner certainly has some clout there, but it's the GBI, the medical examiner, that ultimately makes that decision.
Yes. Anything additional?
If you had asked for dialogue among the candidates, and I think it's important that, first of all, Mr. Bennett, you keep telling people that you are a nurse. You're a licensed practical nurse, correct?
That's correct.
Correct. Mr. Musselman?
It's Musselwhite.
Musselwhite, I'm so sorry.
That's right.
I'm so sorry.
Dialogue, yes. Asking questions directly of each other, no.
Beg pardon. The coroner is responsible for determining how the person died, and it's going to be one of five determinants. And in conjunction with what Mr. Bennett was saying, it is my determination. However, there are factors that are involved, one of which is that family physicians come into play. The vast predominance of deaths in the county are natural deaths. They are not criminal. And so consequently, the need for, I got to stop.
All right, Mr. Bennett, I'll give you the last word.
That's correct. I am a licensed practical nurse. I received that from the state of Georgia based on my military training as a combat medic. And I agree that you have to have a thorough knowledge of medicine in order to look at these cases. And no, I'm not promoting a medical examiner system for Forsyth County. We don't have that number of deaths. But what I am saying is, having worked with a medical examiner for 23 years, I have participated in numerous autopsies and see how the medical examiner works. So I can bring that knowledge and expertise to the office of the coroner for Forsyth County, and thereby enhancing the quality that the citizens of Forsyth County will receive.
Our next question will be led out by Ms. Pais. Ms. Pais, what improvements do you see the coroner's office needing to make in the next few years, and how would you accomplish this?
There are several things that need to be addressed in the coroner's office, one of which happens to be the budget. And as it is in regards to the deputy coroners, is that we need to be a little bit more efficient and effective and utilize them less, and thereby reducing that particular line item. We need to improve our response time relative to motor vehicle accidents. There has been some lengthy calls with regards to that. And we also need to computerize our coroner system. As it stands right now, it's all paper and pencil. It is not computerized per se, and that needs to be updated. Also, in terms of scheduling, we need to schedule with our 911 operators as to who is on call, so that a more efficient means of getting a deputy coroner or a coroner to the scene is more expeditious than it currently is now.
Mr. Mr. Bennett, same question. What improvements do you see the coroner's office needing to make in the next 4 years and having the budget purpose?
Mainly it's the communication with the public. The coroner needs to get involved more in our school systems and with children. When I was at Gwinnett County, one of the programs I instituted over there was taking first offender teenagers involved in alcohol or drug-related deaths. They were required to attend a one-hour seminar held in the morgue where they saw the some of the results of the consequences of their actions. So community involvement from the coroner's office needs to be done. I agree that a computer system does need to be included, and I've been working with the computer system through the medical examiner's office, which I would hope to be able to someday utilize here in Forsyth County. As far as responding to calls, you get to them as quickly as you can. That's a given. The number of deputy coroners and what they receive, I'll address that in a later question, I'm sure.
Mr. Musselwhite?
Yes, sir.
Do you need me to repeat the question?
No, I'm good. Thank you very much. I agree with both of these folks here. You know, we do need a data management system, and it's free to our county. The DOT has a grant in place that would allow us to use this. We can log on online and do it. I don't know what's not being done now. It's a freebie. It costs our county nothing. That's the first thing I'll do. There's some personnel issues that need to be addressed. Could there be better fiscal responsibility in spending? Yes. I'll certainly review the budget and look into those. We do, the coroner's office, I work at funeral home, happen to work for Mr. McDonald, who is the current coroner. We have implemented a program through the funeral home and through the coroner's office that does exactly what Mr. Bennett described. Brings young people in, and it's actually mandated by the court system that takes them through the process, through the embalming process, through prevention, and they see the morgue in death firsthand through very graphic photos. My time's up. Thank
you. Ms. Pais, would you like to add
anything? The only thing I'd like to add is the repeated issue relative to medical examiners is I hope people don't misunderstand. In the state of Georgia, there's only 5 counties that have medical examiners, and those are forensic pathologists. Those are medical doctors that deal with autopsies. And we only have 5 counties out of 159 in the state that have medical examiners. To have them in this county would be extremely costly, and I agree it's not something that we can bring in. As far as community involvement, always. As an educator, it's very important to involve young people. But again, because we don't have a medical examiner here, there would be no place for someone to view a post. And quite honestly, if you've seen enough of them as I have to wonder how valuable that would be in some instances. But as Mr. Musselwhite had illustrated, funeral home certainly could be utilized.
Mr. Bennett, anything additional?
No, I'll give my time to Mr. Musselwhite since he ran over this time last time the question.
Very generous, sir. Thank you, sir. I'd like to finish what I was trying to the point I was trying to make before. There are those programs in place. I think they could be better. You know, I think that we can really vamp it up and make it even better. I was reading last night online about, I think it was in Cherokee County, a program that very similar that is pointed in the direction of youth and underage drinking specifically. And I think that'd be a great program right here in Forsyth County.
Well, since y'all brought it back, our next question will start with Mr. Musselwhite. Please explain how you intend to utilize deputy coroners.
Deputy coroners play a very important role. We do a number of calls here in this county. Not all of them physically require someone to respond to the scene. Sometimes it could be someone who passed away in the hospital in the ER that you know they were there less than 24 hours, and a simple phone call could resolve that. Deputy coroners, having a structured on-call system, and the coroner being plugged into that and taking calls as well, is how I would intend to continue to utilize the deputies.
Ms. Pett?
We currently have 3 deputy coroners, and they're extremely valuable. Is certainly I can't be on call 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. There has to be time when someone else can take call. However, if you look historically at the coroner's office, is that the deputy coroners have taken the vast number of calls. And as such, our budget for the coroner's office is way out of whack. So, albeit they're wonderful people, they do a wonderful job, they're my right arm, and I need them, they cannot, you know, I cannot expect them to be on call as much as they currently are.
Mr. Bennett?
In regards to the deputy coroners, that true, they are on call, but they don't get paid for making telephone calls. They only get paid for going out to the scene on a call. Last year, in the budget designated for the deputy coroners, not all of it was used. The money that was unused was given back to the county. So it wasn't money that was tucked away for the coroner to use in other things. There's a strict accounting on what can be given to the deputies. And you, there again, you cannot regulate the number of death calls that you're going to have. Having speaking from experience, 1 week you may have 1 or 2 calls. The next week you could end up with 30 calls. So there's, unless you can predict when a person's going to die like your crystal ball, then the deputy coroners are important, and the medical and the coroner himself has to be up to stuff.
And I'd just like to expand on what I was saying. Last year, one of our deputy coroners right here, and she was recognized through, I think the AJC did an article, and Forsyth County News surely did, several of the different media sources in the area recognized one of the ladies that is a deputy coroner now for her role in the Child Fatality Review Board. So, you know, deputy coroners play a vital role in the coroner's office. Do the deputy coroners necessarily, or should they do the coroner's job? No. But they play a vital role in answering those calls and taking some of that burden off of the coroner, because he cannot or she cannot truly respond to every single call.
Ms. Patterson, any addition? Anything you'd like to add?
No, I agree. Beyond 24/7, and your deputy coroners are very valuable to you, and you depend upon them to help.
Mr. Pitt, is that an issue?
No.
Well, looking back at my notes, I should have started that question with you. I apologize, so I'll start this next question for you. Can the coroner's office be run more efficiently? And if so, how would you do that?
The coroner's office could definitely be run more efficiently. Not speaking ill of the previous or current coroner, he didn't go out on that many calls himself. He sent the deputy coroners out on them. And I feel that the coroner needs to be in touch with the community and what's going on. He's getting paid a salary whether he goes or not. By golly, he needs to be out there and go. He can't just sit back and draw a check and not expect to do the work.
Mr. Musselwhite?
Do you mind making a
question? Can the coroner's office be run more efficiently? And if so, what would you do to accomplish that?
Sure. I'm a firm believer in there's always room for improvement. And certainly, I've kind of had a unique position because I've been able to see behind the curtain, if you will, having worked with the current coroner. One of the major improvements would be to implement the electronic data management system. That's a no-brainer. It's free to us. It would allow us to work remotely, and it would allow us to better respond to the citizens of the county. We could better serve our community by each of us, whomever gets admitted as elected, by serving our community by plugging in and Certainly. I think there's all room for improvement.
Ms. Pais, do you need me to repeat the question?
I think it's incumbent upon anyone who is trying to obtain a position is that you take the position and you review the processes that are in place and you look at the standard operating procedure. And yes, it can be more efficient. One of the line items that I mentioned was the deputy coroner role. They are paid per diem for each case that they go out on. And they took a tremendous number of calls last year, recent years. This can be curtailed. But in terms of all the other aspects, there is more to a coroner's office than simply going out on call. As Mr. Musselwhite alluded to, there's a pediatric fatality committee that you must attend, you must be a participant of. There's an entire wealth of community resources that have to be participated in. And all of those things need to be done and done efficiently and effectively. And I'd like to be able to do that.
Mr. Bennett, anything additional?
No, I agree. The Child Fatality Review Board is extremely important. That was instituted so that we could protect our children from abuse and mistreatment by their parents. I know that how important it is because I headed that through Gwinnett County for about 6 years. And worked with the district attorney's office over there and on monthly reports. So I'm very familiar with that. And they were right. The young lady who's been working with the current coroner on that has received numerous accolades for her work in that. She's a very dedicated individual. And quite honestly, I would hope that if I was elected coroner, I'd still be able to utilize her services in that regard.
Yes, sir. Just a couple more things I'd like to add. I left out before. I think, you know, just coming up here in July, our state's going to implement a new electronic death certificate. And as coroner, I would be an advocate for using that. That would speed up families getting those death certificates. Mr. Bennett was talking about that before, and that's one way that we can really speed that up. And I would love to spearhead that here in this county and really trying to get our vital records on board and using that, our funeral homes on board and using that. Because that could help close that gap quite a bit. One more thing is building intergovernmental relationships, expanding on those that we already have, and reaching out across county lines even where appropriate to try and build some alliances and improve our services to the community.
Ms. Pais, final word.
Excuse me.
Final word on the question.
Again. I had mentioned early on about computerizing.
Your mic's not on.
Yes, it is.
Yes,
it is. Gee, most people think I have a mouth the size of a ear. I had mentioned early on that we needed to computerize the system, and because it is paper and pencil currently, with very limited amount of computer data being generated, and it is imperative that we do this. We've got to bring up the coroner's office to a more current level, in particular as it regards death certificates. People need to have these documents in order to finalize their loved ones' paperwork and to move forward and to obtain oftentimes financial remuneration. So I agree.
We're back on our schedule. We should have been on. So we'll start. You get to lead off this question.
Okay.
Why are you a Republican, and with which Republican principle do you most identify?
I'm a Republican because, quite honestly, my parents were Republicans in a very Democratic state. I originally came from Ohio, and I can assure you there's an awful lot of Democrats there. But my parents were staunch Republicans. And I am as well. I'm a conservative, and I believe in fiscal responsibility. And certainly, I wouldn't be anything else.
Mr. Bennett?
I'm a Republican because I believe in the Republican Party. I've been a Republican since I was 18 years old.
and I believe in the ideals that they have, that the government is of the people, for the people, and by the people. Big government, such as they're having in Washington, D.C., it continues to put us further and further in debt. And personally, I'll be glad when we see them out of there in November. My personal belief, you know, I believe everybody has the right to express themselves. Everybody in my family is Republican except my oldest son, and he's a Democrat. But I try not to discourage him too much from being wrong.
Mr. Musselwhite, again, as you're running to be the Republican nominee right. for coroner, why are you a Republican?
I'm a Republican
principles do you most identify with?
I'm a Republican because I believe in less government. I believe in better physical spending in our political offices, in our elected offices, in our government. I believe in old world values. I'm a conservative too. I believe in family values. That's all I have to say.
Ms. Pais, would you like to add anything? Mr. Bennett, would you like to add anything? Mr. Musselwhite, you have a minute if you want to add anything.
I'll give my time back to Mr. Bennett.
that's fine. All right. Again, we'd like to make sure that folks are still, they say they're Republicans, but you've been working with the Republican Party. Mr. Bennett, who did you vote for in the 2008 presidential election?
John McCain and Sarah Palin, and I don't need a microphone to voice that.
Mr. Musselwhite?
I also voted for Senator McCain. Okay.
Mr. Bennett?
Sarah Palin.
Well, we're glad that you thought you had it bring. We're always looking for good conservative folks to take office. These are important offices, as you know, and I appreciate your time very much. The party appreciates your time. We especially appreciate all the folks out in the gallery who are watching and want to learn more about this office. At this point, we have our closing statements. We'll start with Ms. Pace and work our way back to the right. But you have a minute and a half.
Thank you, all of you, for staying. It's most appreciated. This is certainly not a position that people inherently want to hear about. They don't really want to see you. But it is a very important one, and I would be delighted if you would consider me to be your next coroner on July 31st. And as they say in politics, vote early, vote often.
Mr. Musselwhite.
Yes, sir. Thank you all again for being here. I've decided to run for this position, not because it's a glamorous position. I mean, in reality, as we're talking about death and we're talking about seeing some things that I know a lot of you probably wouldn't care to see, I'm running for this position because I really feel like I can do a good job for the community. I feel like my background and experience has led me to this, and I have some fresh ideas that could take us to great places within the corner of the world. Thank you for your time. Vote Musselwhite July 31st.
Mr. Bennett, closing statement.
Again, I'd like to thank the Republican Party for hosting this debate. Also, I'd like to say that for the last 23 years, I've worked with death investigations and I've dealt with families. And dealing with families, 300 to 500 cases a year, dealing with families, I have seen grief. I have worked with them. You have to have compassion. You have to have feelings. You have to understand. One thing I've had students ask me when I've lectured classes is that, well, what if this person was a mass murderer? That's fine, they could be a mass murderer, but somebody's his mother. That mother deserves the respect of knowing that her child is going to, at least be buried properly. And the job of the coroner is to ensure that that death certificate and that process is accomplished as soon as possible. I appreciate your vote on July 9th through the 31st because you have advanced absentee voting. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Let's give them a round of applause. Thank you all for joining us. We'll look forward to seeing you on Monday night. We'll be hosting a debate between our 7th District Congressional candidates and the 9th District Congressional candidates.
It'll be next Monday night, the 25th, 6:30 here. And then on Wednesday, the 27th, we'll be hosting the debate for the State House 26 and State Senate 27 district. So we'll look forward to seeing you next week, 6:30. Next slide.
Can you hear me speak?
Yeah.
Oh, that was very good job.
Great.
Good idea.
Well, everybody did a great job. Are you the son of the Democrat?
Oh, for sure.
Well, you're not a Democrat.
I'm not.
Well, you live in the whole county.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I
was
going to stand up and be like, yes.
He lives in
Fulton
County. He could
vote for Forsyth County.
Oh, yes, he would.
Yes,
he would.
Yes, he would.
Yes, he would. Yes, he would.
Yes, he would.
Yes, he would. Yes,
maybe it's got Lauren McDonald on this side.
I learned more from this than I've already heard this year.
No.
We all
know. No, thank you.
On a blog called aboutforsyth.com.
Okay.
So the others who weren't able to come can still hear the debate.
I have several people that called me today and said I want to be there. I'm just not able to make it. So I'm glad you did film it.
You do a nice job, Mr. Underwood. You really do.
Busted my knee.